body is capable of doing many things that we can see, and many things that we can't. For example,
the things you can see our body doing is build a muscle,
or fight an infection or flu. Although we think we can't see it fighting an infection or flu,
we get fevers, which indicates
that we are.
And
we obviously see pregnancy
in women.
Other things that we don't see our body do is its cycle when it goes into fermentation.
Or our heart
pumping blood to our other organs. And we don't see nutritional ketosis. Today, I will talk to you about what nutritional ketosis is, how the body goes into this state, and how long it takes for the body to go into the state. To begin, Merriam-Webster has defined ketones
as a class of organic compounds characterized by
carbon groups attached to carbons.
This is
just the atom that it is. So I'm going to show you the difference between
ketosis and your normal
body energy. Okay, so to start off, glucose in normal energy is then created
for insulin, and then the cells create that
into energy.
In ketosis,
if you can see, there is
the glucose fall,
and then lipase releases
those triglycerides,
and then your liver is the one who breaks down the fatty acids in order to get the energy. So there is a difference between ketosis and the ketone bodies. Ketone bodies is created during ketosis,
but ketone bodies is what is broken down with fatty acids
and is released through the urine. So how is it that we know if our body is in ketosis or it's not? There are many ways to find out. So one way is by ketone strips. You dip it in your urine and it's either a light purple or a really dark purple. Light purple indicates that you're not in ketosis, and then dark purple indicates that you are. And you can also get your blood drawn or your breath tested. So now that you know what ketones are and what ketosis generally is, let me explain to you how your body goes into this. So ketosis is generally by the macronutrients that you eat. So let me explain to you what macronutrients are for a little. So macronutrients are what you eat, and it
consists of three major compounds. So you have your fats, you have your proteins, and you have your carbohydrates. If you've seen on the nutrition label
with like cereal or pretty much anything that
you eat nowadays, it tells you your carbohydrates, your calories, and those are broken down for you.
And these are what you need to watch in order to get your body into ketosis. So now, ketosis is by a different diet or by the way that you eat, different from a regular diet, because normally your fats and your proteins equals, so your carbohydrates are usually higher. And everything consists of carbohydrates nowadays. For example, carbohydrates will be like your breads, your tortillas, your pastas. Your protein is like your chicken, your fish. And your
fats can be like avocados or possibly your fruits or even oils. So this is what you're consuming in your body. And they're
different because in ketosis,
you normally eat less than 5 grams of your carbohydrates.
This is what makes
your body look
for more energy, because when the body
runs out of sugar,
which are your carbohydrates, it wants to look for more in order to make energy. So since there are no longer carbohydrates, since you're eating very, very little of it.
For example, let's say
you have a container like this,
and your carbohydrates are low, your body is unable to get anything from
there or any energy. So now it has to be looking around. And the first thing it goes for is your fats. So usually when people are starting to gain weight, it's because fats are stored in your body. And when these fats are stored, usually they do not get touched anymore because we don't usually watch if we're eating carbohydrates or not. So when we're not eating carbohydrates, your body wants to go and get those fatty acids, break them down, and create energy. So your body uses ketone bodies, the processor energy that is broken down with the fatty acids, usually happens in your liver. And this is how ketosis starts. So let me show you a diagram to further explain how macronutrients are helping the body. Okay, so if you can see on the top, you have your carbohydrates, your fats, and your proteins. Carbohydrates are for your glucose, which causes body fat. Your fats are for your fatty acids, and then your proteins are your amino acids. So if you go a little bit over, your glucose is what creates your insulin. That's why in a ketosis state, your insulin drops because you are no longer eating those carbohydrates. But if you see, let me go back to your fats and proteins, if you follow that diagram, you will see that it's a fuel for the cell, and then it can generate into ketones. So not necessarily are carbohydrates and fats and all that important in your diet, but you don't really need to be eating carbohydrates in order to get energy. And your body actually feels better eating less carbohydrates because that's more of your processed foods and foods that your body doesn't want. So now that we know how your body gets into this state, let me explain to you how long it takes for your body to get into this. So usually your body takes up to 2 days if you have not consumed more than 5% of carbohydrates within the prior 2 days. So say on a Monday, I consumed my 5% of carbohydrates and then my normal percent of proteins and fats. Then the next day I consumed that same amount. I can be almost guaranteed that my body is now in the ketosis state and it is no longer feeding off the carbohydrates, but now it is going into my fatty acids and creating those into energy. And how I said previously, if you are not sure that your body is in ketosis, there are also many ways of knowing if it is or if it's not. So now that you know what ketosis is and how your body goes into that state and how long your body is in that state, you can now further knowledge yourself and use it for your diets or your own health.